Hello, my friends and fellow modelers. This is Stelios Demiras from Mr. Black Publications, and today I have you something different. A sergeant from 101 Airborne Division, 1944 to 1945. This is a resin figure produced a long time ago, but is one of the best, I think, for me, from Mini Soldiers. And it depicts very nice the characteristics of a tough US American soldier of the period, an airborne. I had in my stock for a long time. I have it clean and I didn't have the courage to go on and paint it, as I have a question what to do with the gun, because it's a little tricky how to put it here in realistic form. You see, it's difficult hold it in the Thompson and glue the arm later. It was a little difficult decision, but I decided to glue everything in place, and I had some small accident, but this is resin, you can fix it very easily. Anyway, this is the first layer after the gray primer from spray. As you know, I have a pre-shading technique with brushes on a black glazing, I can say. I use game color with glaze medium. Why? Because I wanted to delay the drying time a little and to have more matte surface. Glaze medium, even you don't believe it, this is a product that dilute the color without losing any of the covering. So and also delays the drying time, so the color will sit in the crevices and leave a little highlight in the other areas, in the more exposed areas. Now it's almost black, because after the initial primer with black, I also make this, and now it's ready to receive the white dry brush technique. I will use this one, and don't forget to stir it very, very well, because the acrylics have the tendency to sit down in the bottom of the bottle. You must have very thick paint for dry brush technique, okay, and a lot of paper to clean the brush. I bought for me from the cosmetics a light. It's a little smooth, as you can see. Of course, there are a lot of different brushes for dry brushing. It you must find what you should see to you in your what you are doing, because now the figures, resin figures, are very delicate, so probably you need to not to push a lot, or not to have a hard hair, stiff. You must have more elastic hair. So what you do? You take the color a little here. You must clean it as you can before you start. Let's let's see how this is doing. You see, it's getting nice. Don't push hard, very light. Very light. And is appreciating that will give you an idea how to paint and where to put the highlights and shadows. Okay, if you want, you can stop here. But for me, now I can say it's okay. And we can go for the painting. You can start with the very diluted paints to see how this will fit. Here also you can make a little more. And you can follow the sculpting of the figure, but you can see that this already is giving you an image on how you will use the lights and the shadows in the figure. So don't hesitate it and test this one, this technique. It's very easy, no airbrush needed. And it's quite beautiful. I must say that I lost the other part of the chin strap, this one. So probably I will make a scratch one, or I will remove also the other, because in a lot of cases they remove it after the landing. I will see what I'll do. Also here we have something that I didn't. Now it's better. So you will see more later. See you later.